I'm Effie, and I am a student supervisor at the Jacobs Hall Makerspace. In this tutorial, I'm going to walk you through the process of 3D modeling and 3D printing a simple chess set. This tutorial assumes that you have a basic understanding of Rhino, which is a computer-aided design software program. If you're unfamiliar with Rhino, you may want to check out our other Rhino resources first before starting this tutorial. You can find those through the link in our description or by clicking the info card in the top corner here. But if you feel like you're ready to go, let's open up Rhino and get started. First, you'll need to find an image of chess piece profiles. A simple Google image search will bring up plenty of options, so just choose one that you like and save it to your computer. In Rhino, we'll place it in our front viewport using the picture frame command. I like to snap my bottom left corner at 0, 0 and hold shift and then drag it out to wherever you want. We'll worry about scaling it properly later. Next, you want to lock this so that you don't accidentally snap to anything weird. And in terms of O snaps, I like to keep end, mid, and int on at all times. And we're also going to be using near right now to trace out the profile. I also like to keep smart track just in case. It can help me align some stuff. So moving on to the profile, we're going to use the polyline command to draw out the base axis and vertical axis of our pawn. So we can draw out the side profile in 2D and then rotate it into a 3D object afterwards. So holding shift in the polyline command, you can create orthogonal lines like this, just to keep everything at 90 degrees. Then to create the top part of the pawn, I'm going to use the arc command to draw a half circle. So again, I'm just going to eyeball where the center is, go out to the end, and then snap it down. Then for the rest of the profile, I'm going to use polyline, curve, and arc again to trace out the rest of these curves. Great, now you have the general outline of your profile. I'm going to drag it out to the side so you can see it. Don't forget to also draw the bottom line, because when we revolve it into a 3D object later, we want that base to be there so that it's a closed object. Alright, now I'm going to use trim to get rid of any excess line work. And then fill it to soften this angle right here. And join it into one open curve that starts at the top of my vertical axis and ends at the bottom. All right, let's move on to 3D. So I'm going to go into perspective, select my curve, and use the revolve command to turn it into a 3D object. So I'm going to start at the base of my vertical axis and end at the top. So I want to revolve it in the Z axis and starting at 0, revolving all the way around 360 degrees. I'll put this in shaded view so you can see what that looks like in 3D. And you have your chess piece. The last thing you want to do before sending it to the 3D printing software is to check for water tightness using the volume command. If it automatically outputs a volume up in the top left corner, you're good to go. If not, it means your profile probably isn't perfectly vertical, your curve isn't centered, or your revolve wasn't complete. You can check for openings with the Show Edges command and click on Naked Edges. This will analyze your object for any edges that aren't perfectly aligned. Finally, we want to make sure that the chess piece is at a reasonable scale. So for this piece, I'm going to scale the height to 32 millimeters. So how I'm going to do that is I'm going to create a bounding box. And then using the bounding box, I'm going to scale with my chest piece selected from the bottom to the top 32 mm. Great. Then go into document properties to double check that your document units, which are right here, are in millimeters. You want to make sure that your document is in millimeters. Yes, scale your model, because almost all 3D printing softwares import objects in millimeter scale. Now you're all set to send this to the 3D printing software. So we're going to export and create an STL file out of it. You can accept the default export options. And now we'll head into our 3D printing software. At Jacobs, we have several 3D printing options in terms of printers, as well as ways to submit your print job. We recommend using our 3D printer OS system, which is outlined by Nicole Canditti in this video here. Check out the info card. So for today, I'm going to demonstrate using the Cura software, which is directly connected to our Ultimaker 3D printers if you're at Jacobs Hall. 3D printing softwares are relatively similar in their user interfaces, so this demo should be a pretty good representation of the steps you might take regardless of the printer you're using. When you first open Cura, you're gonna first want to import your file. So clicking on this folder, I'm going to import the pawn that we just made. Before you print, you want to check a couple things. First, your materials are up here. Jacobs has dual extruders. So the first will be your actual material, which is just generic PLA. And the second extruder we use for breakaway support material. Next, you're going to want to look at your print settings. So for profiles, you can do 0.1 for a high quality slow print, or you can change it to 0.2 for a low quality fast print. If you want something in between, medium quality, medium speed, you can do 0.15. Next, for infill, I usually stick between 20 to 40% infill, but sometimes you may want 100% if you really need your piece to be completely solid. Finally, you want to check support and adhesion. So for support, we have some areas you can see in red that will need support material because the overhang is over a certain angle. So that we'll assign to extruder 2, which is our breakaway material. And then we're also going to check adhesion, which will create a brim around the base of our piece so that our 3D print can adhere to the print bed better, and it'll result in fewer failed print jobs. Finally, I'll put infill at 30. I'm going to slice the piece, and we can preview what the print is going to look like. So here you can drag to see the print animation for that layer. And up here to the right, you can go through all the layers that the printer is going to go through. Once you have that all set up, you can save it to a USB drive to send to the printer. You can save it to a file as a G-code, or if you're connected to Cura Connect, you can send it to the printer directly. Once it's on the printer, make sure to watch the first few layers of your print just to make sure it's going smoothly, and then you can come back later to pick up the finished piece. Hopefully this tutorial has shown you how easy it is to 3D model components in Rhino and then turn it into a physical prototype through the Jacobs Hall Makerspace resources. Happy printing!